You told me that you learned to sing mantras in the bathtub when you were a little boy.
Yes.
Do you remember some of the first ones you learned?
Sure. My dad would be splashing me and I'd be splashing him in the bathtub. And he would go, om, and I would go, om. And then he'd go, om mani, and I'd go, om mani. And he'd go, om mani padme, and I'd go, om mani padme, and om mani padme hum. Then we start doing it together. Om mani padme, I'm splashing our hands in the water. Om mani padme hum, mani padme hum, om mani padme hum, mani padme hum, mani padme hum, mani padme hum. And just giggling and squealing, you know, with daddy in the bathtub. And it really actually isn't much more than that, you know.
And do you teach him yoga now?
A little bit. Sometimes we travel together through geographic expeditions. We go to Central Asia, Bhutan, Tibet, Sri Lanka, Mongolia, India. And the next trip is the Footsteps of the Buddha, January 11th through the 18th with an extension. I'm hoping to get on that trip. It'll be a tour of all the actual locations where the Buddha had his life's journey. And all the temples that are built and those holy sites. And I teach yoga in the morning on those trips. And then he does meditation after lunch and after dinner. I do a little more of his meditation than he does of my yoga. All the yoga that I do is his because he gave me the body along with my mother, Nena.
So is having your dad as a mentor complicated ever?
No. He's always really supportive of whatever I'm doing, whether I'm in show business or whether I'm in holistic healing or public speaking. And he's very determined that I finish college, even though I'm 38. I did drop out, and so that's sometimes, you know, he's a very traditional academic scholar, and he wants me to complete that, you know, someday.
Why?
Just that's what he knows. That's the establishment that gives him a lot of credentials, and parents want to give their children everything they can, and not every parent can give that. And so that's all. He just wants me to be able to receive everything he can give without feeling like it's not me or something. So I can take everything, I can take all of his power, and people can say, wow, your class was just like your dad, or you look just like your sister, and it doesn't take anything away from me. It's still me.
You have to work at that? I would think that would be hard.
It comes and goes. In some ways it was natural, but I think, yes, when I turned about 32, I started to constructively individuate. So it means I have all the power of my parents in my body and in my behavior, but I also have my own power.